The James Webb Space Telescope has captured some truly incredible images of our universe since it was launched in 2021. Countless glittering stars, dense cosmic dust clouds, and vast swirling galaxies have all come right into focus. But we didn't send JWST to space just to bring us new desktop backgrounds, although those are pretty nice. We sent it up there to help us do science and learn about our universe, which doesn't always come with jaw-dropping photos. So here are some groundbreaking discoveries that JWST has made possible that you might not have seen on Instagram. More than 5,000 planets have been discovered outside our solar system, and they're made up of everything from seas of molten lava to methane ice. But aside from some broad observations, it's been a challenge to determine the specific composition of most exoplanets' atmospheres. But now, thanks to JWST, that's all set to change. Lying 700 light-years from Earth, Boca Prins is an immense gas giant that's 1.27 times the size of Jupiter, but only about a quarter of Jupiter's mass. And this planet is insanely hot, like upwards of 900 degrees Celsius, because it sits so close to its local star, which it completely orbits every 4.1 days. And when it eclipses this star, some of that light is absorbed by or transmitted through the gases in the planet's atmosphere. JWST was able to detect infrared transmissions that passed through Boca Prins' atmosphere, which helped researchers determine its composition. This data has given us the most detailed breakdown of any exoplanet's atmosphere that we've ever been able to observe. They found that its atmosphere contains water, sodium, potassium, and even sulfur dioxide, another planetary gas not yet seen in planetary atmospheres outside our own solar system. And it's the first evidence for photochemical reactions, or reactions that are caused by starlight, on any planet outside our solar system. Light from Boca Prins' star splits water into hydrogen and hydroxyl, and these molecules react with hydrogen sulfide in the atmosphere to produce sulfur dioxide. A similar reaction on Earth produces the ozone gas in our ozone layer, which protects us from most of the sun's UV radiation and makes our Earth habitable. So photochemistry on exoplanets could be essential in preparing them for life. If we want to find life out there, we could start looking specifically at the planets where this is happening. As it turns out, JWST isn't just letting us get up-close looks at planets. It's letting us see the stuff inside galaxies. Our universe is absolutely littered with a type of organic molecules called polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, or PAHs. And thanks to JWST, these PAHs may be able to tell us how the universe changes over time. PAHs produce bright infrared emissions when they're excited by the ultraviolet light radiating from young stars, which lets us trace the rate of star formation and other changing conditions in these galaxies. Researchers have long hypothesized that PAHs wouldn't be able to survive in a really high-energy system, like, say, the kind of system surrounding a supermassive black hole. These are called active galaxies, and because of the supermassive black holes at their centers, they can emit thousands of times more energy than a normal galaxy. Infrared data from JWST allowed researchers to analyze PAHs in the heart of three active galaxies for the first time ever. As it turns out, that extra energy isn't as damaging to bigger PAHs as researchers previously thought. The beefy PAH molecules can survive and thrive in these extremely harsh conditions, even while their punier cousins are probably smushed. So why are PAHs so important? Well, it comes back to that light they give off when young stars form. See, the role that supermassive black holes play in star formation has been a bit of a mystery in astronomy. New simulations suggest that supermassive black holes may suppress star formation, which is a pretty brand new hypothesis. So if we can use PAHs to study how many new stars are forming, even in high-energy systems like those around supermassive black holes, they can give us clues about whether the simulations really line up with astronomical observations. Which is pretty possum. JWST is also giving us an up-close look at what happens when two stars love each other very, very much. This unusual JWST discovery involves a pair of blisteringly hot stars that orbit one another, known together as the WOLF-RAYET 140 system. They're surrounded by at least 17 concentric rings that look like a giant cosmic fingerprint, and how this fingerprint formed is fascinating. The pair are located over 5,000 light-years from Earth and consist of a blue supergiant and a kind of star called a WOLF-RAYET, hence the system's name. These star-crossed lovers won't be dancing forever, though. WOLF-RAYET stars are so massive that they burn up their fuel and collapse into black holes, or even explode into supernovas, in only a few hundred thousand years. To put that into context, our sun is around 4.5 billion years old and still kicking, meaning WOLF-RAYET stars are like cosmic fruit flies. And while all stars emit streams of particles into space, the stellar winds from WOLF-RAYET stars push out huge amounts of gases and shoot out those particles along with them. Most are lightweight elements like helium, but sometimes heavier things like carbon manage to hitch a ride too. Researchers figured out that when the two stars and WOLF-RAYET 140 approach each other every 8 years, the heavier carbon gases are compressed into tiny particles of solid material where their winds meet. The dense shells of carbon-rich dust are then pushed out into space at a high speed by radiation pressure, forming those fingerprint rings we can see. And what's more, this sequence of events might be the start of a process that could make a super condensed cloud of dust and gas, ready to collapse and make up future stars. So these two lovers dancing up in the sky might be the first step in the formation of some pretty stellar stuff. Okay. We have one last discovery that this scope has made possible, and this one happens to involve a jaw-droppingly beautiful image, but that's just a bonus. This is the first deep field image taken by JWST, a tiny patch of sky boasting a dense array of glittering galaxies. This one here has been dubbed the Sparkler, since researchers thought the smaller yellow and red dots surrounding it looked like little sparkles. And while the Sparkler is a thing of beauty, a group of five of these unassuming little sparkles may be home to some of the most ancient stars we've ever observed. They're called globular clusters, and they're dense collections of thousands or even millions of the oldest stars that surround galaxies. At least four of those globular clusters are about 4 billion years old by the time we can see them with JWST. But because they're so far away, it's taken around 9 billion years for their light to reach us. So the oldest stars in the clusters could have formed 13 billion years ago. For reference, the entire universe is around 13.8 billion years old, making these clusters some of the oldest stars in the universe. Most people might be more interested in their super pretty friend, but there's a super interesting story going on with the background characters in this stellar picture. Despite all the excitement surrounding JWST's images, it's important to remember that science isn't always a pretty or aesthetic process, and while it can be rare for a discovery to be Pinterest-worthy, that doesn't make the ugly duckling discoveries any less important. So next time you see some jaw-dropping pics of space on Instagram, spare a thought for those less photogenic discoveries that expand our knowledge of the universe. If you liked this video and want to learn more about cutting-edge discoveries about our universe, check out our roundup of some of the space superlatives of 2022. Thanks for watching.